Hello everyone, welcome to part 58 of advanced ecom series in Laravel 7. So in this video we are going to make latest products dynamic at the home page of our e-commerce website. Okay, so in last few videos you have seen that we able to make featured products dynamic. Okay, you can see that we are displaying 5 featured products and they are displaying like this. Okay, so we have done that array chunk, okay, as to display the featured products you have all seen. And we have also done in the previous videos, you already remember that we have made the dynamic menu with the sections, categories and subcategories, and the left sidebar also dynamic with the section, categories and subcategories. Okay, so now in this video we are going to make latest products, new products dynamic, and we are going to show the last few products. Like these are 6 products they are showing, so we can show 6, 9 or 12 products. Okay, it's our choice that we are going to show some products here. Every time if admin is going to upload some new products, those products we are going to show here. Okay, so let's work on this thing right now. Okay, so let's open index controller. So we need to work on index function once again, where we have also done for featured products. Okay, here now we need to do for our new products. Okay, so I will add the query for the new products and I will also remove these unwanted things. Okay, yes. Okay, so here I will get new products. So latest products, now here I will write the query new products, or you can write latest products, it's your choice. So product, and so here I am going to show the latest products. So I will use order by in descending order. Okay, so I'm going to show products. I will see, I will show you the table first. Here you can see that we are having 6 products. So the last product 6 we are going to display at the top, then 5th product will come, then 4th, then 3rd, then 2. So we are going to display the products in descending order, and we are going to display descending order with the help of product ID. Okay, with ID, product ID, we are going to make it descending. So here we are going to write query order by. With the ID, we are going to make descending, means the product ID which is maximum, which is at the last, will come at the top. Okay, so and we are going to show only 6 products. So I will add the limit here to show only 6 products. Okay, I can make it 3 for the testing, and after that I will just use get. And once again I am going to use 2 array to convert it to array. Okay, so this is the another way to get the result in array. Okay, to get the query result in array. Okay, earlier on you already remember that what we have done, we have done the another one. Okay, I will show you once that what we used to do earlier and what is the difference now. Okay, like new products here, now JSON decode and JSON encode. So it will come here new products, and here we will use true to convert it to array, and after that we are going to display like this. So I will show its output here. Refresh, you can see latest 3 products are coming, like with the ID 6, with ID 5, with ID 4. So last 3 products we are showing 6, 5, 4. We have given the limit 3, so last 3 products are coming. Okay, and here we have converted it to array with the help of JSON decode encode. Earlier we used to do like this, but there is one more way to do it. Just simply it will convert to array. We can do like this, to array, we can add at the end of the query, and we can remove this one, then we can display again. Okay, so we have removed one syntax. Now see the output, same output is coming. Okay, you can see the same output is coming we have removed one statement. Okay, so it shorten our code. Okay, so always try to improve your code. Okay, so there are many ways to do the same thing, and slowly but surely we are going to use all the ways one by one, and we are going to use the best way. Okay, and it's your choice that which way you want to use. So we have removed one statement and we are using two array here. Okay, but it does not mean that everywhere we will use two array. We will see, we will keep using both, we will keep using two array. Sometimes two array will not work. Okay, at some cases then we will use JSON decode encode, and it will not work in first when we will just returning one row. When we require just one row, one item, then two array will not work. Then we need to do in the same way like we used to do earlier. Okay, so now also for debugging, I have told you that there are two ways. There is a simple way, we can use DD, but DD is not that much good enough because it will not display in the good manner. So that's why I don't use. Otherwise you can use it like this, DD, then you can display, it will come like this, but then it will, we need to do like this. Okay, so there is the another way. If you can use, you can use this one as well. Okay, DD if you will use, then it will also display. So there are many ways to debug as well. Okay, so let's continue. Now we have the new products, last three new products we are having, and we are going to return these new products to our index.blade file. Okay, along with this featured item count, we will also send new products here. Okay, so I will simply move this one, and I am going to open one new page like earlier we used to do, so that we can display in a proper manner. Okay, so these products we are going to make dynamic, and these are the arrays that we have just taken from our query, and now we need to add for each loop in latest products to show them one by one. Okay, so we need to code for this one. Just open index.blade.php file. Okay, so let's open index.blade.php file, and here we are going to replace this one. See the divs here, li here. First do it like this. First make sure that which thing you, where you want to add the for each loop. Okay, so see 1 2 3 4 5 6, this one is repeating, this li is repeating again and again. So we require just one li, and we can add for each loop, and it is the simple one. No array chunk is required here. Okay, actually the script going here, so that's why we require array chunk. We need to match with the design. Okay, you know that it's automatically sliding. Okay, so that's why we have done with the help of array chunk, we modify our query so that it can match with our design. Okay, but here it is the simple one, just one div need to repeat again and again. So simple for each loop will work here. Okay, so now we will add for each loop here, for each and dollar new products as dollar product, and we will end for each loop here, and for each loop. Okay, fine. Now see, only three times it will show the products. Now let's see now only three times it is coming, because we have added the query just to show the three latest products, last three latest products. Okay, so only three times it is showing, and now we are going to make the product name, and we will show the description here. Okay, and we will also show the image here, all dynamic we are going to make. So first of all, I will use the product name here. So you can show the product name here, CMC casual t-shirt, purple casual t-shirt, black casual t-shirt. So it is coming So now here we are going to show the description. See, if description is short enough, then it is fine. You can show the description here. Otherwise, you can show another things like you can show the prep code, you can show the prep color. Okay, it's your wish. Okay, you can also show the two things together. Okay, you can show the prep code because prep code is the important enough. So instead of description, we can also show the prep code here, because description we can show in prep detail page. If this description is long enough, so code it looks fine. Product name and code is also there, and you can show the color as well. If you want to show the product color, then you can show. It's your choice that which thing you want to show. You can show the color in brackets like this, like this. You can show. Okay, so it's your choice that whatever you want to show, you can show here. So now image, we need to update the image as well, in the same way like we have done for the featured items. Okay, so I will just copy that code, that image code, this one I will just copy and will paste here and will make change if required. Okay, so this image tag I'm going to update like this. Okay, so because we have already done in featured products, so no need to write that code again. Now we can check that whether it is working fine. Product image path we have given, and here we will add the product because we are using product instead of item. Okay, so it's also your choice. Whatever variables you want to use, you can use your own variables. There is no issue at all. Okay, so just the logic, we are writing the syntax must be same, logic must be same, but you can use your own variables, you can use your own design. Okay, so here product image path is fine, and if the product image exists, then we are going to show this product image. Okay, otherwise we will show the no image, that dummy image. Okay, so here we are showing like this. Okay, so see here, it's the medium image we are showing here. There is, I think it is picking. So we require style width, width also is required here, otherwise it is showing two big images. Okay, so style we will give here, like width we can give 50 pixel width, we can give here 50 pixel. You can update in CSS. Okay, see, my CSS is not that much good, so you can ask your designer whatever theme you are going to use. Sorry, 150. Okay, so now it is fine, I think. Yeah, now it looks bit fine. Okay, so it's up to you this thing as well, that if you want to keep both feature products and later products same, then you can keep it them same, otherwise you can make them large as well. We will check the actual page now, that comes with our design. Okay, so that we can match that what's there. Okay, so you can see here featured images and new product images seems to be same here. Okay, there is not much difference. Okay, so I can inspect the original HTML and we'll see here I don't think there is any difference. 160 pixel, and I here also just height is given there, and here also I am going to fetch. So I don't think that there is much difference between the featured images and latest images. Okay, you can see that both seems to be bit fine. Latest product images seems to be bit more, or it seems to be same. This space seems to be more. Okay, so there is not much difference. So it's your choice that you want to show bigger image or you want to show like this. Okay, because there is more space to show. If you want to show the big image, it will also come here, like if you want to increase it 160 pixel, then it will also come here. There is no issue. You can see the 160 pixel image is also coming up. Okay, so it's up to you that you can increase the width, and it will also work in responsive as well. You can I think it will, where it will, sorry, control command I in Mac, I right click inspect. Okay, so here I will just open the mobile mode here, and you can see featured item is working fine. And go to refresh once again, see here featured items and latest products. Latest products also seems to be working fine here. Okay, there seems to be some issue with the featured items in mobile that we are going to see. We can see that issue. Okay, so we can also resolve this featured item issue, whatever issue is coming here. So here you can see that all four products are coming here. Okay, so we are going to check the design, our index design we are going to check. Okay, and we'll see that what's coming in design, and if it is matching design then it is okay. So you can see here the four products are coming, and let's see how it is working. Yeah, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. So all four products are displaying here. Okay, so our design is like this, all the future products are coming like this in design. Okay, and same thing is coming here in our code, and you can see that all the future products are coming here like this. Okay, so here you can see 2, 3, 4. Okay, so but we are going to resolve this issue in future videos. We are going to resolve this mobile responsive issue. We will just show one image. It's the issue in design as well. We are going to resolve this one, and it will show then just four images here. Okay, in the same way like it is showing in desktop. Okay, so that thing we are going to resolve. But one more thing we need to take care of. Here we need to show only the enabled products. Okay, see, disabled products we are not going to show. So if we will disable any product, okay, first of all I'm going to show here the six new products. Okay, so here I'm going to make it six. Okay, last six products, we only having six products right now, but we will add new products later on. See, but last six products we are going to show here. Okay, these are the last six products. Okay, that we are going to show six. It will be like this. This the latest products will come at the top, like 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this one. Okay, so here now one more thing we need to see here, that if we will disable any product from admin panel, then it must not show. Okay, so like if I'm going to disable one of the product from the admin panel, like I'm going to disable this one. Okay, like from here I've disabled this one. You can see this first one I have disabled, so only five latest products must come here, but here it is still coming six. Okay, and it is also product is also appearing in feature products as well. You can see the first one. Okay, it's not the featured product. Okay, I will make it featured. So now you can see the six products are there, but see, the condition is required both in feature products and latest products. Okay, so only those products we are going to show that are enabled. Okay, so I'm going to check here, is featured, yes, and status. One more condition, one more where I'm going to add here, where status must be one. Okay, and same thing I'm going to add for new level products. Okay, and we are going to add it here as well. Now we are going to check, and here you can see only five products must appear. I'm going to check once again that it is working or not. Where status, I'm going to check that what status we have given. Okay, where status is one, that is fine, and here it must work fine. And okay, sorry, here we require here as well, where status one, and here we're going to check once again, still it is not working. Okay, so we need to debug our code now. First of all I am going to check featured items. Okay, so let me see featured items. This one we are going to copy this one and we'll paste here. Here I'm going to check featured items and we'll check up here. Here you can see status one. I think I have used wrong database somewhere. Okay, I'm going to check. And here status all are one. And there is one more issue I find here. The status is not updating. I think I'm going to check once again. Refresh and we'll make it disable. And it is disabled right now. And I'm going to check. Now it is zero. Okay. So now it must work fine. Now I think it will work fine. I am going to disable this one. Okay. So now I'm going to check here. So now you can see the 5 products are coming and here also 5. Okay, so not done that thing quite well. Okay, so 5 feature products are coming here and 5 latest products. So we are going to attempt with another one. Okay, so I am going to disable this black t-shirt now. Done. Okay, so I have disabled. So now I am going to check here at front end. Let's see. Now black must go away. Let's see it will go away or not. And it is gone away. You can see the black t-shirt gone away. Okay, so here only feature products that are coming. Okay, so there is one more thing we need to try. See the feature products now. When you refresh, then it is coming like this, and after some time it appears. So it must not show like this. Okay, then it is appearing. So this one is the another issue. This enable thing we have done here, you can see now every time if the products are enabled, only those products are going to show in featured and latest products. But still there is one more issue. We can see in featured items, and see featured items must only show if the items are there, otherwise it will not show this part. Okay, so we can add here we can add here condition as well. Let us try that if feature item chunk is having value or this one. We can check it feature item here count. We can count this one in fact, I think. And sorry, if count is greater than 0, let me try that if it will resolve this issue. Now still the issue is coming up and you can see feature products 4 products. Okay, so still the issue is there. And we can try in some other way. Here we can move from here and we can add it here as well. Okay, so let me try. Now this time we are going to try here, and I am not sure that it will work or not. It is the tough call, and still it is not working. So it is the design related issue that we are going to resolve this one. Okay, in future videos this one as well. See, feature products are not comes when the products are 4 or less than 4. Okay, so in case of 4 and less than 4, it must show here, but it is not showing. That thing we are going to resolve. Okay, I have one idea here. I can do one thing like this to resolve this issue. See here, this is the class. If I will remove this class, then this issue will get resolved for this 4 product. Okay, you can see here that any number of times you can refresh and it is coming fine, because this class is just required when the products are four, when the products are more than four, okay? When the products are more than four, then we require that script to move the products, okay? That is moving. That slider script we require when only the products are more than four. Otherwise, it must simply display this product, okay? So, see here, we can add one condition here. See, we already having featured item count. So, we can add here one condition. Here we are going to add here we will add count featured item count here is greater than 4, okay, only then this class will appear, then ending like this, okay. So now I'm going to check here, some issue, count featured item count is greater than 4, that is fine. If at rate of if count and let's see, parameter must be an array or an object. Okay, so sorry, this count is not required because we are already having this count variable, okay. See, silly mistake is here, okay. So this one is not required. Now you can see this feature products is coming fine, okay. So first time if you are going to load, it is coming fine, okay. So if the products, feature products are 4 or less than 4, then this condition will work, okay. Just you need to add this condition, if the products are more, then this script will automatically start, okay. So that is also fine now. See few of the things we have done now, and just responsive thing is left, that we will work on it very soon, and rest everything seems to be perfect now, okay. Now it is fine, and we will continue working on other things, like we are going to make this home page sliders dynamic as well. Okay, so that thing we are going to do very soon, and here also you can see that that arrows have also been removed, okay. Like if you are going to show this class, the arrows will also come up there, and in case of four products, that arrow are not required at all. See here, the arrows are coming up, arrows are also coming, and products are also not coming. So major issue we have resolved here, okay. See, the arrows are only required if the products are more than 4, otherwise there is no need to show these arrows, okay, these two arrows, okay. So here add this condition and it will resolve everything, okay. Yeah, this one, okay. So now it is fine, perfect, okay. So see, feature products, later products, and left sidebar and header menu all are working fine, okay. Only responsive thing we are going to update in future videos, okay. And home page header banners are left in home page, that we are also going to make dynamic, okay. So that's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.